world we live in was not made for lesbian, gay, bisexual, or transgender people. As a young and gay Australian, this is something that I am reminded of regularly. Hardly ever do I go a day without hearing words like gay or faggot used as insults. So often do I walk down the street and see a couple holding hands, but almost never are those two people two men or two women. Almost never have I seen a TV character that I felt at all represents me. And I'm reminded even more of this when I read that LGBT youth in Australia are 14 times more likely to kill themselves than their peers. Now, my experience is not a unique one. LGBT people throughout history have experienced discrimination almost everywhere. And a lot of people like to link that to Christianity. So that's what I'm going to talk about today. Now, Christianity has not often been sympathetic to LGBT issues. Indeed, most societies are entrenched within misunderstanding and animosity, which has alienated and pushed lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender people to the fringes of their communities throughout history. We are reminded of this deep divide and discrimination towards LGBT people constantly. For instance, by the example of Russia, where it has been made illegal to talk about homosexuality with minors, or even to publicly acknowledge the existence of LGBT people. This has escalated even more in the last few months, as one region has established several concentration camps where 300 gay and bisexual men have been imprisoned and tortured for simple factors of their sexuality that are beyond anyone's control. When we think of prejudice and fear of LGBT people, it's often taken for granted that religions like Christianity are simply incompatible with these minorities. However, this issue has never been as one-sided as we might like to think. Christianity especially has had a mixed history of accepting LGBT people. Aside from the common tropes of using verses from the Hebrew Bible to vilify gay people, we see other stories of acceptance. We see that largely, the Christian message revolves around love and compassion. Like when we read in John that God is love, or when Jesus tells us simply to love one another. More recently, we also see greater stories of acceptance as the Anglican Church in the USA has begun to accept openly gay and transgender priests. In today's reading, we hear that the kingdom of heaven is like drawing from both the old and the new. That is to say, our truth in the now is not set in stone by our past. Jesus makes it clear to us that our truths can change as our circumstances also change. In other words, while throughout our lives we must constantly relearn and revisit older lessons and truths, we must also incorporate new observations and nuances with our changing world. We need to remember this when we talk and think about LGBT issues and Christianity. Although historically, so many Christians have been completely unable to bring themselves to accept lesbian, gay, and bisexual people, it doesn't mean we can't change this as our world around us also changes. We have to realize that the Bible itself wastes so little breath on condemning or even talking about LGBT people. We also need to realize that society and LGBT people have changed so much in the last 2,000 years of Christian history. We now understand the different ways that we each experience our own gender. And we now understand that two people, regardless of their genders, can love each other. When we read the Bible, we see the old resounding philosophies of love, acceptance, and equality amongst all people, regardless of their gender, race, or their religion. But we can also draw on our new messages and lessons that LGBT people do exist. that LGBT people are our friends, and that they are our colleagues, and that they are our families. What we need to remember is that whether you identify as LGBT or not, we all live together, and we all have struggles, dreams, and emotions, all the same. This is the whole reason we're having a Pride Week here at Melbourne Grammar. What we want to create is a safe and inclusive environment for everyone, no matter their gender or sexuality. And we are getting there. Positive change is definitely occurring. Just look around at you at where you are right now. We're here in our chapel, at an Anglican private boys' school, drenched in historically homophobic tradition. And yet we're all still here, at the end of our Gay Straight Alliance's first ever Pride Week. And I'm standing here talking to you about LGBT people. Now I reckon that's pretty hardcore positive change. And that makes me seriously happy. But we're not quite there. We're not quite there just yet. And we all know that's the case. Everyone here still hears words like fag and gay bandied around as insults. And right now, so many of our family and friends can't legally marry the person that they love. And even more cuttingly, last year it was reported that teenage boys in Australia, people just like all of us right here, would not be happy having a gay person in their friendship group. But the beautiful thing about all of this is that none of this is set in stone. None of this is unchangeable for us. And the reality that we're all facing right now is that we are the people that can be this change. We can leave this chapel today, and we could follow this idea of learning from strong, older lessons of love, acceptance, and equality. And we can use these to make our communities, our friendship groups, and our school here at Melbourne Grammar a safer and more inclusive place for everyone. Lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender people are our family, they are our friends and our colleagues. When we leave from this chapel today, let's all remember and work to see each other's common humanity and realize that we all deserve to live in a safe and understanding world. Let's all hope that we can be the change that makes